The Teatro Lope de Vega is located on Avenida de María Luisa Avenue. It was built in 1929, being its architect Vicente Traver y Tomás. It was the auditorium of the pavilion of the city in the Ibero-American Exhibition. This pavilion had a large room that became the casino of the exhibition. The theater occupied an area of 4,600 square meters and could accommodate 1,100 viewers. Its architecture is Spanish Baroque Revival, being the building faithful to this style both in the set and in its ornamentation. It has served as a place to represent all kinds of shows, and nowadays the most outstanding of the panorama is its programming, national and international, becoming one of the most important theaters in Spain. Others important theaters are Teatro de la Maestranza, Auditorio Rocío Jurado, and Teatro Central. Seville also has a Corral de Comedias theater, which is the Corral del Coliseo, now used as a residential building. There are many entertainment options around the city of Seville, and one of its biggest attractions is the numerous festivals that happen around the year. Some of the festivals concentrate on religion and culture, others focus on the folklore of the area, traditions, and entertainment. Seville is home to the biannual flamenco festival La Bienal, which claims to be the biggest flamenco event worldwide and lasts for nearly a month. In the district of Triana, the Vela de Santiago y Santa Ana is held every July and includes sporting events, performances, and cultural activities as the city honors St. James and St. Anna. Semana Santa is celebrated all over Spain and Latin America, but the celebration in Seville is large and well known as a fiesta of international tourist interest. Local brotherhoods, or costaleros, organize floats and processions throughout the week, reenacting the story of the Passion of Christ. There is traditional music and art incorporated into the processions, making Semana Santa an important source of both material and immaterial Sevillian cultural identity. The April Fair is a huge celebration that takes place in Seville about 2 weeks after the Holy Week. It was previously associated with celebrating livestock, however, nowadays its purpose is to create a fun, cheerful environment tied to the appreciation of the Spanish folklore. During the feria, families, businesses, and organizations set up casetas in which they spend the week dancing, drinking, and socializing. Traditionally, women wear elaborate flamenco dresses and men dress in their best suits. The marquees are set up on a permanent fairground in the district of Los Remedios, in which each street is named after a famous bullfighter. The International Boat Show of Seville is an annual event that takes place in the only indoor maritime port of the country, which is one of the most important in Europe. Seville had a vibrant rock music scene in the 1970s and 1980s with bands like Triana, Alameda, and Smash, who fused Andalusia's traditional flamenco music with British-style progressive rock. The punk rock group Reincidentes and indie band SR Chinaro, as well as singer Kiko Veneno, rose to prominence in the early 1990s. The city's music scene now features rap acts such as SFDK, Mala Rodriguez, Dare Steel, Tote King, Dogma Crew, Bisley de Mara, Hayes, and Gisely. Seville's diverse music scene is reflected in the variety of its club-centered nightlife. The city is also home to many theaters and performance spaces where classical music is performed, including Teatro Lope de Vega, Teatro La Maestranza, Teatro Central, the Real Alcazar Gardens, and the Sala Joaquín Turina. Despite its name, the Sevillana dance, commonly presented as flamenco, is not thought to be of Sevillan origin. However, the folk songs called Sevillanas are authentically Sevillan, as is the four-part dance performed with them. The Triana district in Seville is considered a birthplace of flamenco, where it found its beginning as an expression of the poor and marginalized. Seville's gypsy population, known as flamencos, were instrumental in the development of the art form. While it began as and remains a representation of Andalusian culture, it has also become a national heritage symbol of Spain. There are more flamenco artists in Seville than anywhere else in the country, supporting an entire industry surrounding it and drawing in a significant amount of tourism for the city. The tapas scene is one of the main cultural attractions of the city. People go from one bar to another, enjoying small dishes called tapas. Local specialities include fried and grilled seafood, grilled and stewed meat, spinach with chickpeas, jamón ibérico, lamb kidneys in sherry sauce, snails, caldo de puchero, and gazpacho. A sandwich known as a serranito is the typical and popular version of fast food. Typical desserts from Seville include pastinos, a honey-coated sweet fritter, torrijas, fried slices of bread with honey, roscos fritos, deep-fried sugar-coated ring donuts, magdalenas or fairy cakes, yemas de San Leandro, which provide the city's convents with a source of revenue, and tortas de aceite, a thin sugar-coated cake made with olive oil. Polvorones and manticados are traditional Christmas products, whereas pastinos and torrijas are typically consumed during the Holy Week. Bitter Seville oranges grow on trees lining the city streets. Formerly, large quantities were collected and exported to Britain to be used in marmalade. Today the fruit is used predominantly as compost locally, rather than as a foodstuff. According to legend, the Arabs brought the bitter orange to Seville from East Asia via Iraq around the 10th century to beautify and perfume their patios and gardens, as well as to provide shade. The flowers of the tree are a source of neroli oil, commonly used in perfumery and in skin lotions for massage. Seville is the most populated city in southern Spain, and has the largest GDP of any in Andalusia, accounting for 1/4 of its total GDP. All municipalities in the metropolitan area depend directly or indirectly on Seville's economy, while agriculture dominates the economy of the smaller villages, with some industrial activity localized in industrial parks. The Diputación de Sevilla, with provincial headquarters in the antiguo Cuartel de Caballería on Avenida Menéndez Pelayo, provides public services to distant villages that they cannot provide themselves. The economic activity of Seville cannot be detached from the geographical and urban context of the city. The capital of Andalusia is the center of a growing metropolitan area. Aside from traditional neighborhoods such as Santa Cruz, Triana and others, those further away from the center, such as Nervión, Sevilla Este, and El Porvenir have seen recent economic growth. Until the economic crisis of 2007, this urban area saw significant population growth and the development of new industrial and commercial parks. During this period, availability of infrastructure in the city contributed to the growth of an economy dominated by the service sector, but in which industry still holds a considerable place. The 1990s saw massive growth in investment in infrastructure in Seville, largely due to its hosting of the Universal Exposition of Seville in 1992. This economic development of the city and its urban area is supported by good transportation links to other Spanish cities, including a high-speed AV railway connection to Madrid, and a new international airport. Seville has the only inland port in Spain, located 80 kilometers from the mouth of the river Guadalquivir. This harbor complex offers access to the Atlantic and the Mediterranean and allows trade in goods between the south of Spain and Europe, the Middle East and North Africa. The port has undergone reorganization. Annual tonnage rose to 5.3 million tons of goods in 2006. Cartuja 93 is a research and development park, employing 15,000 persons. The Sevilla Tower skyscraper was started in March 2008 and was completed in 2015. With a height of 180.5 meters and 40 floors, it's the tallest building in Andalusia. Seville has conference facilities, including the Conference and Convention Center. Its Parque Tecnológico y Aeronáutico Aeropolis is focused on the aircraft industry. Outside of Seville are 9 PS20 solar power towers which use the city's sunny weather to provide most of it with clean and renewable energy. The Consejo Superior de Investigaciones Científicas en Sevilla is based in the former pavilion of Peru in the María Luisa Park. In April 2008, the City Council of Seville provided a grant to renovate the building to create the Casa de la Ciencia to encourage popular interest in science. The internationally recognized company Neocodex has its headquarters in Seville. It maintains the first and largest DNA bank in Spain and has made significant contributions to scientific research in genetics. Seville is also considered an important technological and research center for renewable energy and the aeronautics industry. The output of the research centers in Seville and universities working in tandem with city government and the numerous local technology companies have made Seville a leader among Spanish cities in technological research and development. The Parque Científico Tecnológico Cartuja 93 is a nexus of private and public investment in various fields of research. Principal fields of innovation and research are telecommunications, new technologies, biotechnology, environment, and renewable energy.